Types of pupils. Pupils are divided into mainly three types. First one is that orthotropous pupil. Orthotropous pupil is also known as straight pupil. This is known as a straight pupil. So generally, orthotropous pupil is the main character of gymnosperms. Most all gymnosperms. Having the orthotropous pupil, example the syphus. In Andersen's Otelia, so in this one, it is known as the funiculus. It is known as the microphyte. It is known as the chalaza. Right? So, funiculus. Base of the ovule is known as the chalaza. Apical part of the ovule is not covered by the integument, that is known as a microphyte. This all are arranged on the straight line. Okay? So that is known as the orthotropous ovule. So inside that orthotropous ovule, so required tissue is known as the nucellus. This nucellus having that embryo sac. And another ovule. In this body of the ovule bend towards the funiculus. Okay? Body of the ovule bend towards the funiculus. Okay? Then body of the ovule showing of the curvature of the degree, it means towards the funiculus 180 degrees. So this anatomous ovules is also known as inverted ovule. It is most common in angiosperm plants. The object of it is most common in all angiosperms, mostly inverted ovule is present. In the inverted ovule, it means so body of the ovule bent towards the funiculus at 180 degrees. It means in this ovule, microphyte and funiculus both are closely arranging each other. It is a microphyte. So it is known as a it is a funiculus. Both are arranging closely. Okay, that is known as a inverted ovule. Sometimes funiculus is grow above the hilum point. It is known as hilum. So then sometimes funiculus is grow beyond the hilum to form a ridge-like structure. So this ridge-like structure is known as the object, is the object to be. So generally, which ovule having the raphe? And of course, ovule having the raphe. Example, sunflower, ostracy, family. After that, comphylotropous ovule. So in the comphylotropous ovule, example is the bean family. So in the bean family, generally, it is a funiculus. It is known as a funiculus. It is the body of the ovule. So this body of the ovule bent towards the funiculus, exact is at 90 degrees. Okay? Body of the ovule bent towards the funiculus at 90 degrees. So that is known as non-final purpose soil. In this, so all ovule having inside the embryo sac a female gametophyte is present. This female gametophyte is just like that curve or bend. Okay. So example, bean from bean and pea. So there are the three types of ovules. So ovules are three types based on position of microphyte to the follicles. Based on position of microphyte to the follicles. Okay, ovules are three types. In out of three ovules, which ovule is lies in which ovule microphyte lies close to the follicles? That is the object of it. According to the sequence, first one is the anatropous, after the non-phanerotropous, after the orthotropous. Based on microphyte arrange near to folliculus. Okay, first preference anatropous, second one is the non-phanerotropous, third one is orthotropous, that is known as the objective point. This is known as sequence. Okay, this is known as the types of ovule. After the megasporogenesis. So megasporogenesis means what is the meaning? So ovule having that inside the diploid tissue. So that is known as that okay, eucellus. So eucellus having that food material, it providing nourishment, it providing food material to development to the embryo sac. It providing nourishment to the embryo sac. Okay. Next one is the megasporogenesis. Megasporogenesis means, for example, ovary having the diploid tissue. Ovary having the diploid tissue is known as eucellus. So inside the eucellus, one cell is considered as a megaspore mother cell. So this megaspore mother cell is megaspore mother cell undergoes meiotic division, producing four haploid megaspores. Okay, four haploid megaspores. Four haploid megaspores form from single megaspore mother cell. This formation is known as the megasporogenesis. Okay, by meiotic division. Okay, so four megaspores form from single megaspore mother cell by meiotic division. So that is known as that megasporogenesis. That is known as megasporogenesis. After that, development of the embryo sac and structure of embryo sac. Female gametophyte or embryo cell, and structure of embryo cell. In the development of the female gametophyte or embryo cell, and structure of embryo cell or female gametophyte. So generally it is at four, is known as megaspore mother cell. Undergoes meiotic division, producing four haploid megaspores, that is known as four haploid megaspores, that is known as megasporogenesis. So then four megaspores, three are degenerate, remaining one is functional, that is functional megaspore. So it is a functional megaspore. So this functional megaspore undergoes pre-nuclear division. Three are degenerated, only remaining functional, that is known as the chalazal region. Functional megaspore is formed from the chalazal region. So this functional megaspores undergoes pre-nuclear division. In that first division, they are producing of the two nuclei, that is known as the dyad cells. After again division is occurred, the producing of the four. The first division, after that second division. So this is not four, it means two are present chalazal region and two are present microvillus region. Again, another division is occurred, producing totally four. Totally eight nucleus are formed by, okay, three types of meiotic divisions. By three types of meiotic divisions up to 7 meiotic divisions. By 7 meiotic divisions producing 8 nuclei. This is objectively. But how many times? 3 times or 3 generations. Okay? So out of that, in this totally 4, in out of 4, one polar nuclei present towards the center. In this also, out of 4, one polar nuclei, okay, present towards the center. So in this process, at micropylar region, three cell, three nuclei, and after that At the Telangana region, three nuclei are present. At the center, remaining two nuclei are present at the center location. So at the microphylla region, okay, cell wall formation is occurred. At the Telangana region, cell wall formation is occurred. But at the center, okay, cell wall formation is not occurred. Okay, so by the process reproducing of the embryo cell, it is known as the structure of embryo cell. So in the structure of embryo cell, it is formed from single functional megaspore, that is known as the monosporic type. It is known as monosporic type. Example, polygonum plant. Polygonum, monosporic type. Example, polygonum plant. In this, it is known as the structure of embryo sac. It is a female gametophyte. It has towards the microphylla region three cells. Okay, it is known as the completely egg apparatus. So this egg apparatus having mainly three cells, by the cell wall formation is occurred by three nuclei to form that cells. In the egg apparatus, mainly three cells are present. Two are synergic cells, one is that egg cell. Two synergic cells having the finger like projections, so they are known as filiform apparatus. Filiform apparatus, right? So it is the cytoplasm of synergic cells, so that is known as egg apparatus. Egg apparatus having mainly three cells, two synergids, one egg cell. So that is known as egg apparatus, present towards the microphylla region. After that, at the center, two polar nuclei are present, they are not covered with cell wall. So that is known as the secondary nucleus. After that, towards the Telangana region, again three nuclei are covered by the cell wall, so they are known as the antipodal cells. Okay, first one, this is the structure of embryo sac identified by that polygonum plant by Strasburger scientist. Okay, it is this embryo sac is formed from single functional megaspore, so that's why it is known as a monosporic type. Okay, this functional megaspore is present, so towards the Telangana region. It means this okay, seven cell 3 plus 2 plus 3 so 7 cells and 8 nuclei. Embryo sac is formed from okay single function megaspore, so that is known as monosporic type, identified by the okay Strasburger. This embryo cell. Okay. Next, towards that okay microphylla region, three cells are present. That is known as egg apparatus. Egg apparatus having mainly three cells. egg cell. On either side of the egg cell, two cells are present, they are known as synergy cells. This synergy cells having the nucleus and cytoplasm, and above that, okay, finger-like projections, they are known as filiform operators. The role of synergy cells, okay, so at the time of fertilization, it means, so pollen tube move towards the embryo sac. Pollen tube move towards the embryo sac by the directing of filiform operators. When the filiform operators producing chemicals, by the chemicals, pollen tube, okay, attracted, move towards that, okay, embryo sac. Okay, next, pollen tube enter into the embryo sac by the bursting of one synergy cell. So that is the role of synergy cell. After that, at the center, secondary nucleus is present. So it is the largest cell of the embryo sac. Two polar nuclei present at the center, that is the largest cell of embryo sac. After that, remaining, so three cells are present towards the chalazal region. They are known as antipodal cells. So these antipodal cells are smallest cells of the embryo sac. So they are first off before or after fertilization. After fertilization, so it means antipodal cells are first off. Okay, synergy cells are first off. Egg cell is converted to the embryo, and secondary cell or central cell is also known as central cell. Is converted into the primary endosperm nucleus.